So it's a luxury, it's a treat for all of you all watching currently.
Spoken like a true commentator. I tell you what, what a start there for Eugene Wang. Oh, that 8% might be just increasing a little bit after these first couple of points. Excellent work.
Yeah, just super block there. Excellent reaction time from Wang.
Love to. One, two.
So, Ma Long and Eugene Wang met once before in the Slovenia Open in 2012, and Ma Long won in four straight games. Let's see what happens here.
Oh, that's superb, right?
Three,
he
one.
Was right on top, didn't blink an eye at all. Forcing Ma Long to be quicker than what Eugene Wang is.
Mm.
And just so incredible to see him pushing the limits for Ma Long.
Let 3-1. Three, two.
Better here, Ma Long.
Three all.
Well, and if you get an early lead, and especially when you get an early lead from Ma Long, against Ma Long rather, you want to protect that. And I'm sure that service error would have hurt Eugene Wang a bit.
Three,
nice back and opening with a lot of spin. Nice to see Eugene Wang bringing in his A game forward so far.
Five,
yeah,
three.
Sometimes you just need a bit of that as well when you're up against the goat.
Well, luck favors the brave.
Three.
This lead increased to three. Excellent from Eugene Wang.
Oh, that was a brilliant
three,
one.
Seven.
A very soft backhand loop without any spin in the ball. It's totally unexpected. And the Canadian now leads 7-3. In game one.
4-7.
Yeah, sometimes, just sometimes, the bigger name just takes a bit of time to get going. I mean, it's not normally like Ma Long to be like this, but we've seen it already, haven't we, on table one, where the higher ranked player just takes a bit of time to warm up.
8-4.
Eugene Wang is maintaining this lead. Ma Long beat Gaston Aldo of Argentina in straight games in his first round matches. 11-8 was the best result, or 8-11 that Gaston Aldo had. Eugene Wang is playing doubles as well. Won his first round match, and he beat Benc Majoros of Hungary. 4-2.
8-5.
In his opening round match. That lead is down to three. Bearing down now on Eugene Wang.
Three, seven.
Three
eight.
In a row, isn't it, for Ma Long? Much better from him.
Yeah, and a very vocal Ma Long.
Again, not something you necessarily see so early on in a match. Well, this has been excellent from Ma Long. And Eugene Wang's got to be thinking about that really impressive lead he had. 4 points whittled away.
Nice backhand. Oh, I'm sorry, forehand serve with a lot of backspin in it. Just immense.
Back in the lead here, Eugene Wang.
And there you see the step around forehand, right in the center on the body, finding those right spots so nicely.
Eugene Wang is playing some blinding shots here so far, and he's got game point.
I mean, he's outdoing Ma Long in the fast game. How good and brilliant is that?
This one, if he gets this, well, that will confound all those fan predictions. But there's no discounting this man, Ma Long. Clutch time for him. I say clutch time, it's only the opening game, but he doesn't want to give a game away, does he? Oh, how well was that? Got right under it. Perfect for Ma Long. And he has now got his own game point.
Yeah, that was a good opening by Eugene Wang on his serve. But, well, Ma Long doing Ma Long things. Coming right back with the wonderful forehand attack.
Now, can he convert his first game point here?
11 all.
Eugene Wang still in this.
Yeah, pinning in really well onto the backhand side. Putting it extreme backhand so that he can stop Ma Long from stepping around.
The second game point for Ma Long now.
Such an intense pressure situation here.
Well, he doesn't like that. He's saved a couple of game points now, Eugene Wang. Not making this easy for Ma Long by any stretch.
Yeah, that was a brilliant, just a simple block on the backhand side. Ma Long was not ready for it. He actually thought that it would go out a winner. But Eugene Wang was right there, reading the game so very well.
Just heard some shouts of Ma Long in the crowd.
Again, outdoing him in his own speed. That was a brilliant down-the-line backhand. Look at that. So confident. Eugene Wang's been super amazing so far, and he leads one game point.
Second game point now that he's had. Eugene Wang, can he convert? Oh, what a rally.
He's done it, yes.
Oh, he's taken it. I thought...
Side. Did it?
13 all.
I thought, well, Eugene Wang...
Side.
It hits the side. Let's have a look here. There was a bit of contention. Actually, that is, that's off the edge, isn't it?
Umpire's decision.
Well, the umpire says it hit the side.
What do you think?
And the point has gone to Ma Long.
Well, he can't believe it, Eugene Wang. And actually, I don't know, Ma Long kind of didn't say anything.
He didn't contest
it. He didn't do any, yeah.
Yeah.
What do you feel? Do you think that was the edge or the side?
13 all.
Well, the umpire's given their decision and we're back in the game. It's 13 all.
Leha.
Yeah, Eugene Wang isn't happy. He's not able to control that.
You know what you were saying about being in the moment? That is hard. That is hard to put down.
Very hard. Very hard. I mean, he could have taken a game off Ma Long.
Yeah. And you know what's going to happen now, right? You know exactly what's going to happen.
13.
Though to his credit, yeah, he's still thinking about it. You can't blame him. That's human.
Yeah, the face says it all.
Here we go. Go on, Neha.
Well, it seemed like that side, but that's table tennis for you, right? The margins are so fine.
True, true.
So fine.
So that's the edge for you then, yeah? I think we all kind of knew that was going to happen next. Unsettling him.
Yeah.
But also, there's probably going to be a reaction from Ma Long. You weren't getting this close again, right?
Yeah, you can see that right there in the first point. I feel Eugene Wang is still frustrated from what happened in game one.
Yeah.
I mean, he could have taken a game off Ma Long, the greatest of all times.
Absolutely. I mean, he's pretty much stepping toe-to-toe at the moment, Ma Long, right? He's not getting vastly outplayed by him by any stretch. You know, yesterday we talked about... There was an earlier block in there, which is excellent. We talked about Ossian Belrose. Remember him against Wang Jujin? He took a game off the world number two. And I know Eugene Wang's a much better player. Much higher-ranked player, but still, six of the last eight. You want to be able to say you've taken a game off him.
Yeah, and if you do that the World Championships, it makes
even
it
better, right?
Even better. Because
this is Marlon's event. This is his tournament. He's owned it. Yeah, what to be. What to... nothing you can do about that. He's got his first point on the board here, but it's a different Marlon, isn't it, in game two? He's kind of been stung into action, hasn't he, after how close it was?
Yeah. Now it seems like that no mercy. I'm going to get. Yeah. I'm going to go for every single ball there.
Yeah. I mean,
2-5.
Sometimes, you know, you need a game to go against you just to spark you into life, almost go against you, spark you into life, right?
And it's still only round of 64.
Yeah, that's very true.
Now, nice. Just simply wonderful forehand. And it's kind of helping Eugene Wang if he's sitting right on top of the ball, because you can outdo Ma Long in the fast game, can you?
Yeah.
It's hard to be faster than somebody who's just probably the fastest in the world.
Six, three.
Yeah, he's up for it now.
Three, seven.
Oh, that is classic Ma Long, isn't it?
Yeah, just look at the intense fitness levels required here to be doing all of that, Shehzad. I mean, he's the best in the world,
yeah.
Two-time Olympic singles medal winner, and you've done various sports and just fitness levels in various sports.
Oh, absolutely.
How does it?
Especially at this age group, right? At this age band. He's in his mid-30s. He looks lean. He's so fit. And yeah, I mean, sportsmen at that level, at that age, have to do everything. You talked about Sharad Kamal, and he's spending more time off the table than on it.
Yeah, and as modern sports science is increasing, there's so much technology,
yeah.
There's so much knowledge coming in. I think the longevity of elite athletes, they're able to take it much more longer in their careers versus, they say that the 30s are your new 20s.
Absolutely. If only I could remember that.
11-4.
Good there for UG1.
To be able to play at varied conditions.
Yeah, it is very different here as well in South Africa. So Marlon looking a lot more comfortable now in that second game. Oh. What a fantastic point for Eugene Wang. Wonderful shot selection.
That was a bit of a snake there from Eugene Wang.
Yeah, when he's back in that mood, the one we saw in game one, he really can match up with Ma Long at times.
Oh, brilliant, right? Again, so quick, Eugene Wang. You know, it seems like he's got so many weapons. He's fast on his feet. He's got that brilliant wrist work. But the mark of an elite athlete is that can you repeat that many times? Can you maintain that consistency? And you can clearly see Ma Long is a more consistent player versus
Eugene
Wang.
That's the difference, isn't it?
Yeah. That's actually what separates you, you know, and you can see the difference in the world rank there.
Mm. Yeah, Eugene Wang is in the lower reaches of the table now.
2-3.
You know, these are also like life moments, you know, once in the lifetime opportunities playing the dictator, the dragon Ma Long at the World Championships.
Does well there, Ma Long. I mean, remember, it was only a year ago that he was in the top 50, Eugene Wang. So that's still a long way away from Ma Long, but you can see the quality that he brings literally to the table. That's what we're talking about.
4-3.
Absolutely brilliant retrieval. I mean, he's sitting right there. Look at how composed he is. He's not threatened by that forehand from Ma Long, but he's there to give it back.
Yeah, he is indeed.
I mean, talk about guts.
Yeah, he's shown that tremendously, hasn't he? He's really, at times, been a handful. These are the rallies that fans want to see.
Yeah, when Ma Long hits his forehand, I mean, look at the body, right? It can be so threatening because he literally exerts all that he has into every single shot. But for Eugene Wang to keep giving it back, I'm giving a huge salute to him right now.
Totally with you on that.
3-5.
Shake of the head from Eugene Wang. He's been at a number of Olympics already for Canada when he was eligible to compete for them. 2012 games.
7-3.
2016 and 2020. Moved from China to Canada. But Ma Long has started to surge away from Eugene Wang. Just too good, Ma Long. How about that?
Table tennis at its best. That step around forehand.
Just created that little space for himself. Brilliant.
Yeah, I mean, if you're a young, upcoming table tennis player, I'm sure you'll go back to your training today and want to be doing that Ma Long step around forehand.
3-10.
7 game points here.
Ma Long.
Well, excellent from Ma Long here.
Oh, yeah, I mean, for sure. It actually seems like that, well, players at that level, you know, you can match their intensity. It gives so much self-confidence, actually, because from the outside, if you look at the world rankings, there's such a contrast. Mm. But if you look at every single point, Ma Long has to play his A game. He's have to exert Love so to. Well. And just kudos to Eugene Wang. So everyone who's watching feels that, okay, there is some
there
chance.
Is something, yeah.
Love three.
And there he calls for a timeout. Yeah, probably the first game where we saw that bit of a contention in the edge ball. That probably would have been the right
time. Oh, that particular, you narrowed it down to that moment, yeah. Mm.
Because you rarely get those opportunities and you want to capitalize on that. So timeout, using it very well, has of profound importance.
Mm.
And also that would have just maybe settled him and the coach would have said, just don't worry about it.
Yeah, you only have one timeout in an entire match.
Right.
So you want to always use it very judiciously.
Especially when you're...
2-4.
On the verge of beating Ma Long in a game. You want to secure that, don't you? Ma Long wins this game and this match is done. Oh, lovely. Very nicely done from Eugene Wang.
So impressive. I mean, the ball went so low. Look at how low he went and retrieved that. Just brilliant. And then the next one pouncing on it like a lion. But, well, Ma Long makes the comeback. You do something for me.
I'll do it.
Well, wait and watch.
Yeah. Came up with a lot more determination in that one.
Oh. 6-3.
That forehand again from Ma Long. We saw the montage of those earlier.
Yeah, so deceptive. Until he actually makes the contact, you don't know where it's coming.
Yeah.
So you got to react super quick. A brilliant
3-7.
Serve there to set him for a nice flick on the forehand side. And that's why serves are so critical in the game of table tennis.
Yeah.
And that's one thing which is always under your control.
4-7.
Which Eugene Wang did pretty well there on his serve.
Yeah, a very heavy backspin serve.
See, these are the
7-5.
Kind of shots he can produce. Eugene Wang, as you said, the difference is he can't do it as consistently as a Ma Long.
Oh. 8-5.
And at this point in this match, it's a bit of a desperation from Eugene Wong. And he's trying his best, but the best is not enough today in front of this legend of the game.
5-9.
Oh, six, that was a brilliant nine. One. An excellent backhand spin and then step around from the forehand side. Look at how confident Eugene Wong looks. It's just a brilliant down-the-line forehand attack.
I'll tell you what's interesting here as we set up match points, and I probably should have brought it up earlier, is he's got one of the highest percentages of win rates against Chinese players that I've seen. 56%. And he puts it away. Ma Long excellently. Just to finish up what I was saying.